July 2018 for the intermediate fly tying box. We're going to work on some foam grasshoppers. I thought it would be fun to crank a few of these out for you guys going into the summer. So what we're using here, this is a number 8 2220 Daiichi hook. I'm using 6-aught uni thread. And the first thing we'll do is attach our thread towards the front of the hook, and then let's try to lay down a nice even layer of thread, because this will actually be visible on the underbelly of the fly. So we want it to be nice and neat, no real big gaps or anything like that. So just take a minute and lay down a nice layer, working our way back to our tie-in point. And then we'll turn right around and come right above the point of the hook right there. What I have is some pre-cut foam. This is 6mm tan foam. So I'm going to send this to you guys all pre-cut out like that. So that'll be nice. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to lay this on here. And we're going to tie that in. So once I position that, that first groove should be about where our thread is. Let's start though. I'm going to put just a tiny drop of glue right here on the thread. And we'll hold that very carefully against the hook there. And we'll come around and make one wrap and add a little tension, like so. And let's pull our foam up, come up underneath. Carefully make nice, clean, neat, even wraps, probably at about the midway point of our hook shank, and that should be pretty close to where our next groove is. So we'll repeat that, hold the foam down, add a little tension there. We'll add some glue to the underbody here when we're finished now. So for the wing, I've got some tan suede stuff that I found at the craft store. It makes a pretty cool wing. I've just clipped it, shaped it to match kind of the size of the body. And this is like a paper product, but it makes a natural looking wing. So I'm just going to position it there and carefully tie that down in that same groove right there. And we can snip off the paper like that. Okay, now we need to put on some legs. I'm going to send you guys some really cool injection molded hopper legs. So we're going to take those. They come in a pair like that. You can just pluck them off. And we're going to tie that down on each side right there in that middle groove on both sides. But this is critical. You do need a drop of glue right there. Otherwise, these legs will not secure in there. So once I've got that little glue in there, just take your thumbnail, hold it in place, and then we can come around with our thread and make a couple pretty good tight wraps. Keep in mind we're still wrapping in that same groove on the underbody. Alright, let's repeat that on the opposite side. So just take a little tiny bit of Zappa Gap and just get some right down in that groove. And now we can hold that hopper leg right on there and secure that in with three or four good tight wraps and let that glue bite down in there. Okay, so there's the main body of the fly. I'm going to put a little bit of red yarn on top there just to add a little visibility to this fly, and it just makes it look a little cleaner and neater. A little polypropylene yarn. I'm just taking a little bit like this. And I'm going to tie it down right in that same groove. Again, we're doing everything in that same section there. A couple good turns. And then I'm going to take, to really clean up that top part, I've got some 2mm foam to match the color there. Let's just pull everything back right there. And lay that foam right on top. We can come around and secure that right in place there. Okay, so there's the main part of the fly. We need to advance our thread to the next section there. So I can, instead of coming up underneath this time, I'm gonna actually cross over the top and secure that front part down. We can take this top foam and we can secure that down as well. Actually like it to bite down in there. All right, now we need some front legs. I've just got some kind of a brownish colored barred leg. I'm gonna take one strand on this side. Oops, got a little glue there still. And let's do the same on the opposite side. Just hold it in place. Let's pull everything back up and just make some good tight wraps up underneath and cover up that front section of the hook shank there. I'm just going to lay a little thread base right up underneath there, and then we can whip finish and trim everything down. All right, let's trim the legs down to shape there, to size. Both there, we can trim this front part, top of the foam down, like that. Now, hopefully our underbody is fairly even there, and we can take a little glue and just come back now and just be careful, don't really mess this up too much. Just get a little bit down in that section there, and that makes this fly a lot more durable. All right, now we can add a little curb appeal to this. Let's make them into a hopper now. So let's put an eyeball on each side. Amazing what that does to a hopper. And let's put some stripes on these legs with just a Sharpie here. Okay, we really wanted to get crazy. Take a red Sharpie here, maybe add a little red to the feet here. Do as much as you want with this. Okay, and that's called a tan Western hopper.